Welcome to PJ's Q&A section.
Hello everybody, welcome back to PJ Chen Design. Today's Q&A section, we have a question about if I want to be a jewelry freelance designer online, which website should I go to find a job? And what kind of portfolio should I prepare for my online freelance profile? Let's get started.
There are four websites I would like to show you today. The first one is Fiverr. You can find all kind of work in the Fiverr. A lot of the writing, a lot of anything, marketing, animation and music and everything's there. A lot of graphic design work though. For the 3D model and product design, we can go in and then you can kind of looking at what other people do. If you want to go to the Fiverr, you need to set up your account. To be the freelance there, and you can kind of take a look on other people's work and kind of give you an idea for that. For me, it doesn't have a lot of jewelry work, even it does, but it's not too many of them. But if you do a lot of rendering, this is a good website for you to do for the jewelry designer. The second website I would like to talk about is freelance.com. Freelance.com has, again, have all kind of work. Let's go to do a test. Let's type it jewelry design and let's do a search and see what kind of work they have. So right here, you kind of need to bid into it. You have a jewelry design and it will give you a day for you to bid on it. Again, there's a lot of graphic design, even the jewelry is for photo editing, and you don't see much of a jewelry CAD model. Once a while, you will see some, but people like to do graphic design a lot in the freelance.com. And the third one I would like to talk about is Gulu. We want to go here and find a job, and again, we can type it jewelry design. And again, you don't see much. You see a lot of jewelry retouching, graphic design, but not a lot of jewelry CAD work. You have, again, like rest of the three, you have some. But if you not only do the jewelry design, you also do the graphic, those three websites, I will highly recommend you. But I mainly use a lot from the Upwork. In the Upwork, if you type it jewelry design, or you can type it jewelry CAD design to be more specific. So you see here you have custom jewelry, fashion jewelry designer, jewelry, and then so when you look at all those titles, you kind of search on what you will like. So we are going to type in more specific jewelry CAD designer, and they do have option for US only or as international. So let's clear the filter and see more job. All right, so there are 33 job here. This one, fine jewelry CAD designer. Let's get into it and look at it. Alright, so they say they need to hire three freelance, and then they will have the description for what they are looking for. And then you go through the description and see if you like it. It also will show the history of this client, like how many jobs is being posted, how much it's been spending, what is the average hourly rate for all the job is spending, all the money is spending on those jobs. We can also look at this, NECAD designer to design jewelry sketch. So you go into it and then you look at the detail. It will tell you this is by hour job or it is a fixed price. And it also will tell you what kind of label they are looking for. Sometimes they will write it down like certain CAD program like Rhino, Metric, Rhino Go, and see if you fit into the qualification. They sometimes will give you the image of what they are looking for. For example, like this is the work they are looking for. If you think you can do that, you definitely need to apply for it. Let's take one more. Technical drawing for jewelry pendant design. And of course, you need to understand what technical drawing is, and then you look in the job description and see if you can, if you like it. And again, they will have the sample of what they are looking for, or maybe they will give you the sketch for what they are looking for and want you to finish with the better rendering. Okay, so looking at those jobs, they will say what's the criteria, and on the bottom also will post similar job. If you like it, then you will submit a proposal. And when you submit a proposal, oh, right here it say the client is prefer somebody is in the United Kingdom. Too bad. But anyway, those are some criteria they have. They might have some tax requirement to be in the local. Okay, so let's say if you really like it and then you want to submit it and it's showing your hourly rate and then you want to write a cover letter and then you want to drop your portfolio there. And if you run out of the point, you can purchase from the Upwork. Okay, so few things you need to have in mind when you work with Upwork. They charge 20% commission. So whatever you make, they will take 20% of that. That is the funding for them to operate in this website. Okay, let's take a look on my profile here. First, you need to write it down who you are. You don't have to write a lot, just one paragraph is enough. And then you will set up your hourly rate, and then it will list what you have done and people's feedback on that, and of course the project amount, and then they will look at your portfolio or things like that. So you want to put something that you think is going to help you to get a job. And then you have, you know, what current your education and your employment or anything is worth to notice there, you want to put it on your profile. Okay, so let's take a look on other people's profile and see what we can find as an example. So let's go ahead to change here to freelance, and let's type it jewelry designer. Let's see other people's portfolio and see what we can learn from them. All right, so me is showing up here. Here you have another jewelry designer. Let's take a look on her profile. All right, so very clear bulletin of what she can do, and also showing her hourly rate and how much she earned. And people will look at this really carefully. It's about your rating. So always encourage your client to write it up a review for you and write it up, you know, what's their working experience. And then you can see some of her work here. She has a lot of work, like full page. So if a client is interesting and it's fine, okay, this is really similar like what I'm doing here, so they might contact you and give you an invitation. And also has a employment history, is really, really impressed. And also the education things that you can put it up there. So let's go back and take a look on others. This Bonnie, it's okay. So she's working with CAD CAM metrics, jewelry business. This is her hourly rate and how much she earned. And again, with the history, let's take a look on the portfolio. So sometimes you can have a link in to have the portfolio for people to come in here to take a look what you can do, be more clear. Sometimes you can direct people to your website, so that will help as well. So let's take a look on one more on this gentleman here. So again, it was saying what he does, and people were looking at the feedback, and people will look at the portfolio. It doesn't seem has a lot of the portfolio here, but you can kind of, you can do it this your own and kind of browse over and see what kind of a description that it will catch your eyes, and you probably want to do the similar format and write it down in your own way. So you also want to prepare a digital portfolio, and this is something easy, few pages that you can send people a quick digital format for what you do. And those kind of things, you don't have to have a lot of the text. Pretty much people can tell what your ability by looking at the image. So you want to send them something like the CAD model, the sketch, the design process, sort of things like that you put into your portfolio. So basically for people to know you more about what you can do. So when you apply for the job, you can attach this digital format so people were able to know your ability. I hope you enjoyed today's video. Please like and comment and share my video that helped my ranking to reach more people. Thank you, and I'll see you next.